The Tourism Development Authority urged the leisure industry to focus more on sustainable practices as tourist arrivals to the island surge after the end of the three decades war.
You can go on, talk about industries where we had great opportunities, but not necessarily we were able to sustain. Now, we have to turn back and learn from this. And we should not do the same mistake that some of these industries did. What was the mistake they did? The mistake was, when the times are good, most of the people just focus on making money. There was business. If you could just deliver something, there was money. So the mindset was more a trading mindset. Trading is good, it is part of business. But you cannot have a trading mindset for products and services. You have to have a long-term objective. You must create businesses which are sustainable. Therefore, I urge the tourism industry in Sri Lanka to think about sustainable tourism as much as possible.
Sri Lanka plans to attract 2.5 million foreign visitors by 2016, which is expected to generate some $2.75 billion in revenues. In 2010, Sri Lanka had about 22,000 hotel beds, which accommodated around 900,000 tourists. The industry plans to add another 45,000 rooms by 2015, according to official data. Godaheva said the industry should look to build strong relationships with customers, develop brands and uplift the quality of the product to be competitive.
Small and medium time players coming into the industry, which is good. A lot of people come into the industry. But if they don't build brands, if they don't build customer bases, don't think they can survive in the long run. Eventually, only very few will survive if they don't build that relationship. Relationship with the tour operators, relationship with your suppliers, relationship with your ultimate customer, that is so important. Secondly, the quality of the product that you're offering. I mean, today, with our shortage of hotel rooms, any hotel can get business. But when all these hotels which are in the pipeline, more than 9,000 at the moment, are completed, the story is going to be different. Then you are going to really, really compete for market share. Then the customers, the tour operators, are going to be choosy and select the hotels which are offering the right product, the right quality of product, as well as the right service.
He was speaking at the inauguration of the Hotel Show 2012, which began today at Sirimavu Bandaranaike International Memorial Exhibition Centre. The Hotel Show 2012, organized by the Ceylon Hotel School Graduates Association and the Lanka Exhibition and Conference Services, will run till the 15th of this month. Sri Lanka Army is to host Defence Seminar 2012, a three-day international conference to share its post-war experience in reconstruction, resettlement, rehabilitation and reconciliation in former war zone. The seminar scheduled to kick off in August will be attended by military personnel from 63 countries. Over 22, including speakers from US, UK, India and Pakistan, are set to address the three-day seminar.
We are organizing the Defence Seminar 2012 on the subject of towards lasting peace and stability, talking of Sri Lankan experience of the government as well as the role played by the army in a post-conflict scenario, especially on the five R's really, on reconstruction, resettlement, rehabilitation, reintegration and reconciliation. Again, it's a three-day seminar, like last time, same venue, Hotel Galadari, will be held from August 8th to August 10th.
Sir William Alexander Jeffrey, a British civil servant involved in reconciliation efforts in Northern Ireland and Iraq, will be a guest speaker. The Army said US has also confirmed attendance through its embassy in Colombo. Among the top government officials assigned to speak are Gotabaya Rajapaksha, Lalit Weerathunga, Professor Rajiva Weerasinghe, Ajit Niwan Kabral, and ministers Jewel Pieris, Basil Rajapaksha, and Mahinda Samarasinghe. The Development Lotteries Board has introduced a lottery called Super Ball with a 30 million rupee prize. The lottery gives an opportunity to the winner of the day's draw to determine the prize, which is cash or a house and a car. The board seeks to raise its annual contribution to the President Fund by 62.4 million rupees with the new lottery.
මේ මගින් රටට ලොතරේයක් විතරක් නෙමේ සේවාවන් රාශියක් සැපයනවා. ඒ විකුණන රුපියල් විස්සේ මම පෙරකිව වගේ තවදරුවෙකුට අධ්‍යාපනය උසස් ඇස්සර ගැනීමට උසස් අධ්‍යාපනය ලබා දෙනවා. තව පිරිසකට තමන්ගේ ජීවිතයත් මරණයත් තරග තරඟ කරන අයට තමන්ගේ රෝගය සුව කර ගැනීමට මේ අරමුදල් ලබා දෙනවා.
SLT's POTV and Internet Protocol Television has partnered with Union Bank Sri Lanka to offer TV banking services in the island. The service will enable customers to make balance inquiries, utility bill payments, internal fund transfers between accounts and third parties of Union Bank or any other bank. The service will also offer customers to check their assets and liabilities, fixed deposit details through the TV portal at home.
We are trying to give all the facilities on your home TV screen. Now TV banking, from your bedroom, you can do your transactions. Maybe you can give your account details, or you can transfer fund, or you can make a utility payment. That is possible through your TV banking service.
The company targets to increase the customer base to 80,000 by the end of this year from 55,000 current customer base. Official says the TV banking service will be offered freely.
First, you have to get registered with your own bank. Okay. Now, they, as you do it with the internet banking, they will register you for TV banking. And there, you will get a username and a password. And once you come in, you can use that username and password to log in to the TV banking portal. Okay. That will enable you to bank with your own bank. And if you want, you can change your password through your remote controller. So that option is also there. And this is secured. The most important thing when it comes to banking is the security. We know that and we have addressed it so carefully so that no customer will face any issues and they will not have any sort of fear in using TV banking services.
Ice Age Continental Drift, also known as Ice Age 4, an animated adventure comedy movie directed by Steve Martineau and Mike Thirmier, has been released today, foreign media reports said. It's the fourth installment of the Ice Age series being produced by the Blue Sky Studios and distributed by 20th Century Fox.
Welcome aboard, mate.
Hey, this cruise has entertainment.
Seriously?
You can now follow Debrief on YouTube, Twitter, and Facebook.